equipo contra la selección de Chile, que se llevará a cabo a las 4:20 de la tarde aquí en el Estadio Fundación Carlos Slim. Los invitamos a todos a apoyar a ambas selecciones mexicanas.
National anthem rings out here at the Fundación Carlos Slim Trophy. Wales against Northern Ireland. Now the Northern Irish national anthem. Northern Irish national anthem as it gets us into now the Fundación Carlos Slim Trophy fifth and sixth place game here on pitch one. A very good afternoon to you from me, Gavin Wallace. You can join the conversation online by using our hashtag Mexico 2018 HWC reaction interviews and everything you need to know and how you can help us with the Homeless World Cup online now on our website. Go to homelessworldcup.org, the address on your screen now. Having a quick look then at Wales, first of all, last in Group B on day one after losing their first two matches. Day two, they lost to Chile and Northern Ireland, so it's a rerun of the match on day two. Having a look at day four, they lost again to Northern Ireland and then to England, but they beat Paraguay. They've also lost to Scotland again on penalties, and now they are about to take on Northern Ireland. Having a quick look at the Northern Ireland team and what they've been up to. Lost their first two matches to Colombia and Chile. Had 18 goals against them on day one alone. Lost to Egypt 7-2 on the second day, and then on to quarterfinals day, beat the USA 7-6 and beat Paraguay 6-5. So players to look out for on both teams. Lauren Roper, the Welsh goalkeeper. Rhiannon Key there, number 4. Kelly Fitzgeraldine, number 5 as well. And Zoe Parfa also good for Wales, for Ireland on this Battle of Britain for Northern Ireland. Ruth Boyle has been outstanding in goal. Nicola Syme, the captain, number 10. Kira Moss, number 5 for the Northern Irish. And Lisa Donnan has been outstanding as Wales get an early lead with the number 7. Zoe Parfitt. As Kelly Fitzgerald for Wales pushes forward now in a promising position. It's the goal scorer there, number 7, Zoe Parfitt. And it's slotted away effortlessly by Lauren Jones. And Wales now taking a third goal off of the Northern Irish. Zoe Parfitt this time getting in on the act. Wales on the attack again, asking all sorts of questions of the Northern Irish defence. As Parfitt hits the post, they'll come back to Fitzgerald. Plays it out to Lauren Jones. And that's a good effort from Parfitt, but well deflected by Nicola Syme, the Northern Irish captain. That there was a shot of Zoe Parfitt. Was a great save from the Northern Irish goalkeeper. You just seen there though, Zoe Parfitt, the number 7 for Wales, who spent this entire time playing in the Homeless World Cup for 2018 with a tennis ball in her hand. You think it might be a kind of superstitious thing for her. We did ask. But they haven't actually, we did ask the Welsh team to get back to us on that. They haven't done that yet. So if you do know her and you're watching this game, we'd love to know why she does that. It's something that's really intrigued us for the whole tournament. It's something, everyone's got their match rituals and their superstitions. The Indian goalkeeper always rolls into the box, as in roly-poly. As Wales make a sub, Rhiannon Key coming on now. Parfitt, who we were just talking about, has went off just now. She made way. Fitzgerald is the ball. Slack though, it goes to the Irish number 8, Sienna McGuinness, and it's a foul now. And that's a great goal. Nicola Syme stepping up there to put it beyond Lauren Roper on her inside. It's 3-1 now to Wales. Apologies to you if you heard any colourful language there. Our microphones at the side of the park, extremely sensitive. Ofa Nats, not meant, she says. Sienna McGuinness on Rhiannon Key. She insists to the referee there was no malice there. It was just purely accidental. Here it is again. She instantly said sorry. She clearly didn't mean that. It's a good save from the Irish goalkeeper. Remains 3-1, 2.5 minutes left. We will get you an update shortly. As Wales make a substitution now. We will get you an update on Greece-Paraguay just shortly. As Northern Ireland dispatch their penalty with ease. That was Lisa Donnan, the number seven there. As Wales immediately go out the park and hit the bar. The number three for Wales, very unlucky with that. Tina Jones, it was a good effort. As Donnan goes up the park at the moment. The Greece-Paraguay game, Greece are currently down 4-0 to Paraguay. We'll keep you updated on that. Oof, great effort from Nicola Syme. As the reintroduction now of Zoe Parfitt, number seven. And we have actually found out, it's very interesting actually, she has been playing this entire, it's a great effort from the Welsh forward. She's been playing the entire tournament with a tennis ball in her hand. And we have been told that she suffers from a form of anxiety and it's a bit of a calming measure for her, which is really interesting actually and really good of her that she can find playing football. Obviously helps this as well, but she will hold on to that tennis ball really tightly as Donnan scores for Ireland to make it 3-3, Wales, Northern Ireland then 3-3 with 10 seconds left. But yeah, that's the reason that Zoe Parfitt has played the full tournament with the tennis ball in her hand. It just helps calm her anxiety down, and we absolutely applaud her for being able to come out here and play as well. There's the reason the penalty was given. Convinced that she wasn't out of the box, referee thinks differently at the break. 3-3. Second half now underway. Remember, you can join the conversation. We would absolutely love to hear your thoughts and comments. Use the hashtag Mexico2018HWC. And remember, everything you need to know about the Homeless World Cup's a great effort there, by the way, from Fitzgerald. It's online on our website, homelessworldcup.org. If you fancy maybe getting involved with the team, you fancy helping out, or simply want just to donate to help keep the running of the competitions, you'll find all the details on there. Plus, there's some great interviews. Omar Flores of Mexican's men's mixed team has got a fantastic interview there. You can also find out more about the FIFPro Fair Play Award winners. Day one, Greece. Denmark also presented with the Fair Play Award this year as well. And we do a different one each day. As that is a great effort from the Welsh number six. Boyle down there to deny a Welsh onslaught. Northern Ireland playing in the light blue. Stroke teal affair. Wales in the darker green strips. Minute and a half then of the second half. Wales 3, Northern Ireland 3. Referee just deciphering. It's a Northern Irish rolling. Couldn't get it beyond Roper. Roper's dropped it though. Goalkeeper was well down, but she spilled it just outside the box, though McGuinness is there just to make sure and tidy up. Ireland, Northern Ireland through there, number two and number nine there. Danielle Donnelly, the number two. The number nine of Boyle. And it's over the bar. Not much happening in the way of chances in the second half so far in the fifth and sixth place game of the Fundacy and Carlos Slim Trophy. Oh, and that snuck in there. A great effort from Zoe Parfitt. It's a great effort from the Welsh striker. As Wales press again. 4-3 to the Welsh in this Battle of Britain, this British Isles derby. If you want this moved on quite quickly. The Welsh men's team there as well as their backroom staff and supporters. It's a nice crowd gathering this afternoon here in Zocalo, the heart of Mexico City. And wow! That, my friend, is a great goal. Zoe Parfitt again. Who else? She has been outstanding for Wales in this tournament. Oh wow, that's another great goal from the Northern Irish. That's Donnan that time. Lisa Donnan with the reply straight away to make it 5-4 in favour of the Welsh. It's the Northern Irish backroom staff looking on, coaching staff looking on. Northern Ireland press through Donnan, through the legs of Lauren Roper. She managed to get her back heel onto that just as Nicola Syme battling with Kelly Fitzgerald here. Fitzgerald just makes sure her glasses stay on. Occupational hazard then. I know all too well about that. Fitzgerald well back there. And she had a great effort on goal. It's very, she hit, for me, she's been one of the players of the tournament as well, Fitzgerald. As Ireland now have it deep in the Welsh half. Boyle there, the slight trip though. Wales kick it away. Lauren Roper just too much on that. Nicola Syme can't do anything about it. Danielle Donnelly looking on there from the sidelines for Northern Ireland as Wales manufacture another attack, which is broken down though by the Northern Irish, just inside the box for Roper to get another attack on the goal. Oh, that's a great effort. Fitzgerald there, just in case it breaks. Great save from Lauren Roper. and again from Roper. Currently it's Greece 1, Paraguay 6. That's just finished now. So we now know what's happened over there. Greece 1, Paraguay 6, which means Paraguay will finish 7th. Greece finishing 8th. Roll in from the Northern Irish, but Roper there. And that is that. It's finished here as well, as Wales win 5-4 and will finish 5th. Northern Ireland will finish 6th in what has been a great tournament for both teams.